Welcome guys, I am Parinita. Subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to receive regular notifications regarding the computer science topics and technical job updates. Hello guys, I am Parinita and welcome to my channel to polish your CSE concepts with me. So, let's get started. In today's video, we are going to learn about LZW. Now, you must be knowing that in our previous series of data compression videos, we have already seen about LZ77 and LZ78. Now after LZ77 and LZ78, we are having this third type of method, that is LZW. So now we will learn about LZW encoding as well as LZW decoding. So in this particular video, we are going to learn about how to encode any given sequence with the help of LZW method. So here we will see the detailed example. Here one sequence is given, we will directly see the example and its explanation, right? Here we are given one whole sequence. We have to encode this sequence with the help of LZW, and initial dictionary is given to us. As we know, this is a dictionary encoding method. So initial dictionary is already given to us. Mostly whenever they are asking LZW, initial dictionary will be given. In case they are not given, we will keep on making the dictionary as the sequence comes. We will gradually make the dictionary. So here initial dictionary is given, so we will take it first and then we will continue updating the dictionary as per the sequence. So let's start solving it. We will again start with the index and entry. First of all, the four entries are given to us. We will write them as it is because obviously they are our initial entries. So we have to write them as it is. Let's write it as it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. B dash, this is known as B dash or B space or B blank, whatever you can call it. This is not B, see, these are the two different symbols. This is B and this is B blank. So we will call it as B blank. So this is B blank. Then we are having A, B, O, W. This is the dictionary that is given to us, and we will now keep on updating the dictionary as per the sequence characters. Fine. Okay. Now let's keep on updating the dictionary and let's see how it works. First of all, the first thing that we have encountered is W. We will check that whether the code for W is what we are doing here. We are doing encoding. So what we will do, we will take the sequence one by one and we will check whether that sequence is already encoded or not. So first of all, we are having W. We will check that whether the code for W is already present or not. We will check, yes, the code for W is 5. So it is already present. So now I have to take the doublet. Okay, now let me quickly tell you that why LZW has came into existence. Though we are having LZ77 and LZ78, because obviously LZW came into existence after LZ77 and LZ78, because it is kind of better than them. How it is better? We can say that LZW is more customized. In case of LZ77, as we know, we used to send the triplets, and in LZ78 we used to send doublet. But in case of LZW, we will send only one parameter, that is I, index. We will neither send triplet nor doublet, we will only send one parameter, that is the index. So we can say that this LZW is more customized than LZ77 or LZ78. So it is kind of better than them. And apart from that, one more important characteristics of this LZW is that in case of LZW, as we are encountering this sequence, input sequence, and as we are going to encode them in midway also, like for example, I have first of all encoded these 5 characters, I can send that much to the receiver. Again, we can go on sending the receiver as we are encoding here. Like, we don't need to wait for the whole sequence to be encoded and after that we will send to a receiver. It will not happen in this case of LZW. In LZW, we can continuously send the encoded sequence to the receiver in paths. As and when we are encoding here, in the same time we can go on sending to the receiver. Fine. So these are some of the important points regarding this LZW. Fine. Okay. Now we are starting our example. First of all, we have rewritten the given given dictionary, right? Now the first character is W. W is already present in our dictionary. It is already encoded. Yes. So now I will take the doublet, that is WA. Is WA already present? No. So I will add WA here, and it will become my sixth index. It will become my sixth index. But remember that this is my sixth index. But what I will send there? WA is my, I have taken WA as my new entry in the dictionary, and I have to send the code for this W only, for one less, so W only. So the code for W is 5, so I will send 5 here. Let's do one thing. This 5 is what? It is my encoded sequence. So let's write my encoded sequence simultaneously here. So first thing that is my encoded sequence is 5. So first thing that I have sent is 5. Okay, fine. Now the next thing after WA. Okay, one more thing to remember here is, once I have taken WA, after every step I have to repeat with this A. I have to start with this A. The character which you have already taken in the previous step, we have to start with that character only. For example, I have already taken WA, now I will again start with this A. So only A is present. Yes, it is already present in my dictionary. So next I have to go with doublet, that is AB. AB is already present? No. So I can add it. So I will add AB in my dictionary. It will my seventh index, and I have to I have to send the code word for this A. So the code word for A is 2. So I will send 2 here. Fine, I have to send this 2 here. So that is my second code. Then after AB, again I have to check B. B is already present. Yes. So I will take BB. BB is already present. No. So I will add BB in my dictionary in the 8th index. And I will send the code for this B. The code for B is 3. So here I will write, I will send 3. Next, again this one B I have to take. This B again. B is already present, yes, so I have to take BA. BA is already present, no. So I will add BA to my dictionary in the 9th index, and I will send the code for B. The code for B is 3. So again, I have to send 1, 3. Okay, then I have to start with this A. A is already present in my dictionary, yes. So A, B blank. B blank is AB blank. AB blank is already present, no. So I will add AB blank in my dictionary in the index 10, and I will send code for A. So code for A is 2. So after 3, 3, I will send 2. Okay. Then B blank. B blank is already present. Yes. So B blank W. B blank W is already present. No. So I can add. Okay. Let me write it here. After this, I am writing it here. Right. So the next thing that I will send is B blank W. B blank W. In the index number 11, and I have to send the code for B blank. The code for B blank is 1. So here I have to send 1. Okay. Then W, is W already present? Yes, W is present here already in the dictionary. So WA. Is WA already present? Yes. See here, WA. I am taking WA, but WA is again already present here. So I have to take one more thing, one more character. So WAB. Is WAB already present? No. So here I will add WAB in 12th index. And see, this is an important point. In the 12th index, I had to add WAB. I have added WAB. And now I will send the code for WA. So the code for WA is 6. So I will send 6 here. Fine. Okay. Then I have ended at WAB. So I have ended at this B. So again, I have to start with this B. So BB, all the single characters are already present. So BB, is BB already present? Yes, BB is already present here. So I have to take BBA. BB is already present? No. So I will add BBA here in the 13th index, and I will send the code for BB. So the code for BB is 8. So here I have to send 8 here. Okay. Then again I have to start with this A. AB blank. AB blank is already present? No. So I will write AB blank here in the 14th index, and I have to write the code, send the code for A. The code for A is 2. So I will send 2.
AB blank is already present, is it? Oh, AB blank is already present. So AB blank, see, AB blank is already present, so I have to write ABW. So I have to take ABW. ABW is already present? No. AB blank W. So I will write AB blank W here and I will send the code for AB blank. AB blank is 10. So I will send the code 10 here. Right? Okay. The next is WA. Is WA already present? Yes, WA is already present. So I have to take WAB. Right, so I will write WAB here at the 15th index and I will send the code for WA. WAB is again present. See, WA, first of all, I have checked this WA. WA is present? Yes, WA is present here. Then WAB. Is WA present? Yes, WAB is also present here. This is important. WAB is also present here. So I have to take one more character. Taking one more character will give me WABB. So here I will pass WABB here and in the 15th index, and I have to pass the code word for this WAB. So the code word for WAB I have to pass 12. Right, this is important. Here your attention is very important, that you should not miss anything. Right, here I have passed WABB, so the index number 12. Now we are having, next is I will check BA. Is BA already present? Yes, BA is already present in the 9th index. Then we are having BAB blank. BAB blank is already present? No. So I will add BAB blank in 16th index and I will send the code for BA, that is 9. I will send 9 here. Fine. Then we are having B blank W. Is B blank W already present? Yes, B blank W is already present. So I will take 3. B blank WA. Is B blank WA already present? No. So B blank WA I will add in the 17th index and I will send the code for B blank W, that is 11. So I will send 11 here. Fine. Okay. Next. B blank WA. So I have to start from A. AB. Is AB already present? Yes. AB is present here in the 7th index. So I will take ABB. Is ABB already present? No. So I have to add ABB here at the 18th index and I have to send the code for AB. The code for AB is 7. So I will send 7 here. Then after ABB, we are having BA. Right. We are having BA. BA is already present. Yes, BA is already present. Then we are having BAB blank. BAB blank is already present. Yes, BAB blank is already present. So I have to take all the four characters, that is BAB blank W, in my 19th index and I will send the code for BAB blank, that is 16. So at the end I will send 16. So yes, this is my encoded sequence of the given sequence and I have encoded it with the help of LZW. So it is a simple method. You just remember the thing that wherever you are stopping, you have to start with the same character in the next iteration. This is one of the important points. And as I have told, solve this question very carefully, then you cannot go wrong. It is very easy, right? Now in the next video, we will see how to decode any given sequence with the help of LZW. I hope you have understood this thing. If you like the video, please like and let me know in the comment section and share it with your friends too. Thank you so much.